Hello, my loves. Liz Ann here from High Vibes Life, helping you make the rest of your life the best of your life. And if you haven't already, please subscribe now so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. In this video, I want to talk to you a little bit about self-loathing and how to start looking at yourself in the mirror, and instead of saying ugh or I don't like that, or looking at those places and parts of you that you wish you could change, instead looking in the mirror and saying, hey, beautiful. So I know how painful it is to be in a place where we don't want to be who we are. We don't want to look the way we look. To be in a place where you see somebody that's really pretty and just think, must be nice. I have been there so many years, it's way too long, and I have finally made peace with who I am and what I look like. The thing is we are here experiencing life. We're not here to be beauty queens. Of course, that's something that some people have. You look at them and they are stunningly beautiful. And good for them. You know, I hope they're able to use that to make their life more beautiful as well. But we all know beauty does not equal happiness. If you really think about it, what you're looking for is you're looking for approval. You're looking for attention that you may have missed early in life. I really get irritated when I hear people in a derogatory way say, oh, they just want attention. They're just looking for attention. Because I feel like if somebody is looking for attention, they probably damn well need some attention. They probably didn't get the attention that the person is so irritated about them looking for it as they did when they were children. And yes, they need some attention and they need some validation. Unfortunately, the kind of attention that they're looking for and the way they're presenting themselves to receive that attention isn't really what they need. What they needed was their parents' love, approval, and validation, their unconditional love. And somewhere, somehow, that was missing. So the best way to overcome any type of self-loathing is to start giving yourself the attention that you missed out on, to start finding ways to love yourself unconditionally. It's a process, it's work. You have to go back into your childhood and you have to work through messages that you received back then, and you have to go back as an adult and you have to give that child what it was lacking when they were a little child. When a memory comes up on a regular basis, you could go into that memory as an adult. You could observe it from the outside looking in and you could think, what does that child need to be able to assuage that situation that they just went through, instead of coming away from this message of I'm no good, I'm unloved, I'm bad, I'm ugly, or whatever they came away from. What would it have taken at that time for that child that you're looking at now to get the love and the validation and the nurturing that they needed to come away with, I'm okay, and this wasn't my fault, and I'm a good person, and I love myself? What would they need? And then you go in as that adult and you give them that. This can be a painful process, and you may cry. Often you will. And it's okay. And just realize that even as you cry, it's okay, because it's cathartic. You're releasing it. You're letting it go and you're bringing in a new message to that child. There's been times when I've gone back to an old memory and I've seen somebody hurting an aspect of me at a certain age. And I've actually gone to the adult first in that memory and I've pushed him across the room like superpowers. Wham! Who do you think you are treating this child like that? You know, because I knew that that child needed to witness somebody coming in and showing them how wrong it was for that person to be doing what they were doing to that child. So it would be just like if you went in and you caught that person doing whatever they were doing to that child, what would you do? How would you handle that? And then taking that child out and holding that child, letting that child cry, just taking her to that place of love and validation and letting her know that none of it was her fault or made her a bad person These are the steps that really make a huge impact and take you from a place of self-loathing to self-love. Because self-loathing goes way deeper than like one of my things, my nose, my crooked nose, my broken nose. Self-loathing goes way different than I'm a little overweight or I may be very overweight. Self-loathing goes back to an unacceptance of ourselves at a core level, and it began very early in our formative years. So in order to overcome self-loathing, you need to go back to those formative years and you need to undo some of the messages that you took on and rewrite them. The more you do this and the more you practice affirmations in the mirror and the more you commit to yourself that you're going to love yourself, that you're going to be your own best friend, the more these feelings of self-loathing, these feelings of not wanting to walk in front of a mirror, will start to just fall by the wayside, and you will be able to just look at yourself in the mirror and be who you are and be perfectly happy with her, perfectly at peace with her, and even sometimes have to take a second look and think, man, she is awesome. She is beautiful. So I hope this has been a good message for you, and I hope it's been uplifting and helpful. And if it has, I would appreciate a thumbs up. Also, if you know of anybody else that could use this message, please share it with them. And please don't forget to subscribe. Have a good day.